So now it's time to look at setting up the basic settings of PrestaShop. But before we do that, I want you to spend some time familiarizing yourself with the dashboard and the back end. So just have a click around, go into some of the dummy products here, look at how everything's set up and how everything pieces together. Really spend some time familiarizing yourself with everything and seeing how everything plugs together. This will make your overall PrestaShop experience much more enjoyable. And once you've had a click around and you feel comfortable with everything, the first thing that we need to do is come into the module section. And there will be a number of modules that need updating, which you can see here. So if we come to the top right corner and click on Update All, that will go out and update all of the modules for us in one go. So do that. Once that's complete, you will see a message like this one. And if we just come back to the modules section, we should now see that there are no modules to update. Now, before we start digging through all of the preferences and setting all these settings up, when we installed PrestaShop, it also installed a range of dummy data. For example, we've got all of these recent orders loaded in, sales stats. If we come into the catalog, there are already a range of products set up. Now, what I want to do is delete all of this dummy and sample data so that I can begin to set up my own products and product categories without all of the dummy and sample data getting in the way. So once you familiarize yourself with the dashboard, we can then go about removing all of the dummy data. The first step to that is if you come to the dashboard here and turn demo mode off, you will see here all of these graphs flatline based on our actual orders. Once that's done, we need to go to modules and then modules and scroll down to the search here and do a search for cleaner, and you will see the database cleaner here. Just install that and then you will see a screen like this. So we want to click yes to delete all of the catalog and yes to delete all of the orders and customers. And we can just delete the catalog here and hit OK. That will now delete all of the dummy catalog data for us. Once that is done, you'll see the catalog truncated message here. Now we can do the same for orders and customers. And you see that has been completed here. Next, we want to check and fix the integrity constraints because we've just deleted a large amount of data from the database, and you can see that has fixed. And last but not least, we want to do the database cleaning and optimization, and you will see that has completed for us there. So now when we go to our catalog, you will see that there are no products existing. We have no product categories anymore. We have no order data and no customers. So we're now working with a completely blank install. So let's take a look at working through all of the preferences and settings. So if you go to preferences and general, we can start here. Now, if you want to enable SSL on your site, here is where you do it. You will need a separate certificate from JustHost or whoever your hosting provider is. Most of these settings you can leave at default. Now, remember where each of these settings are in case you want to turn them on or off later. But the only thing I would change here is the main shop activity is for downloads. And so if we just hit save there, we can move on to the next step. Taking a look at our orders processing. Personally, I like to change this to the one-page checkout and enable the guest checkout. Now, the reason we enable the guest checkout is because if you force people to register before they check out, that kills conversion. So please make sure you enable this. These we can leave at default. If you want a terms of service page to appear, there is one set up by default, but I turn this to no personally. And you can also offer gift wrapping if you want, but as we're selling a digital product here, it will not be relevant. So once you're happy with those, hit save. Next, we want to come over to the products settings. Catalog mode allows you to disable the transactional part and the shopping cart part of the site. So if you want to display a static catalog of products, that's where you would do it. But for us, that is irrelevant. You can also redirect people after adding a product to the cart, either to the page they just came from or to the cart summary. Feel free to change that to your personal preference. And you can also force the update of friendly URLs. Now, this is the SEO friendly URLs. Make sure that is set to yes. We have a few options of page nation and how many products are displayed per page, which you can change to your preference here. And on the product page itself, we have a few options. So you can choose whether to display how many products are left in stock. For the sale of digital products, we have unlimited stock, so we can turn that to no. We can also choose some other options here. However, the defaults are already good enough for what we want. We can also change some of the stock options down here. Now, as we're selling digital products, I tend to disable the stock management entirely because we have an unlimited amount of the product to sell. It's just a case of sending an email for the most part. So with those settings set, just hit save. And now we can move on to the customers settings. Registration process type, only account creation. That is perfect for our needs. We don't need address creation because we will be delivering the products digitally. Phone number is mandatory. I turn that to no. There's no need for us to collect the phone number, although if you would like to, just leave that set to yes. Sending an email after registration with the details. Personally, I like to have that enabled. And if you're happy with those settings, just hit save. Next, we're going to take a look at themes. Now, I'm going to do a bit more of a dedicated section on themes a little bit later on, but this is where you come to manage all of your different theme options and change themes. So for now, we don't need to worry about that and can just move on to SEO and URLs. Here you can see all of the different pages we've got created, and you can change the page titles and the SEO URLs here if you want to. But what we're more interested in are the settings down here. Now, by default, these settings are already pretty good. There's not really anything that you need to change here. The only thing I would change is this drop down here, redirect to the canonical URL as a 301. That's the only thing I would change on this page. Once you've done that, hit save. Alternatively, you can also create the robots.txt file. And you do that at the bottom and just click on the generate robots.txt file. And this will just help point Google towards your sitemaps and where it should be spidering and blocked from spidering. So make sure you do that as well. Now let's move on to the CMS options. Here is a list of all of the static pages, such as delivery, legal notices, etc., etc. If you want to edit them, just come along and click on the edit button here. And you will see a what you see is what you get editor to edit the content, along with the ability to set your meta title, description, keywords, the SEO URL, and whether it's indexed by search engines or not, and whether the page is visible on the site. So just remember, that is where you manage all of your static pages. Right now, we're just going to leave that at default. Moving into images. Again, the default options here are good enough. This will automatically create all of the different size images that you need when you upload them along with your product. And if for any reason you need to regenerate thumbnails because things go wrong or after making a lot of changes things don't line up right, you just come into this section here and click on regenerate thumbnails. Moving on to store contacts. If you have multiple stores, for example, brick and mortar businesses, this is where you would come in and add your different stores, which will then be made up of part of the store finder. But as we're a digital product seller only residing online, we can select all of these and delete them. Once they have been deleted, you just want to turn off display in the footer and click on save. And once saved, move on to the next section, which is search. At the top of the page here, you can see references to previous searches. So let's just select those and delete them. And once that is done, you can leave the rest of the search options at default if you ever want to come and change them and give different results more weight than other things. You can come in here and do that. But the default settings are fine for us. We can move on to the maintenance tab. Now in the maintenance tab, we don't really need to do anything. This is just giving us the option to turn on or turn off the shop while we're working on it. But seeing as it's not live yet or we've not actually gone out and advertised anywhere, we can keep the shop enabled. The final setting under preferences to take a look at is geolocation. So if we want multiple versions of our site to be shown to different countries, this is where you do it. You can enable geolocation by IP address and then decide which version of the site different countries see. Seeing as we are going to just be selling digital products, it really doesn't matter. So you can just leave this at default and click save. And that is all of the basic settings for PrestaShop set up. Before we move on, I'd just like to show you some of the advanced settings here. Now, just have a little look around, but the main one I want you to be aware of is once a site's set up and ready to go, we can actually improve the performance and load time of the site just by coming to advanced parameters and performance and coming down here and enabling CCC, which is combine, compress, and cache. So you can just turn these options on, only do this once the site is complete, and then also caching, use cache set to yes down here, and just use the file system cache by default, and press save. Now, you only want to enable this once your site is completely set up. So I'm just going to undo those settings because we're not ready for that yet. But once you have finished setting everything up and you're ready to go live, be sure to come back into advanced parameters and performance and enable all of the caching, which will improve your site load times and the performance across the board.